Ireland and the world, you're so welcome this afternoon to the highlight of the BT Young Scientist and Technology Exhibition 2022. The winners of the BT Young Scientist and Technology Exhibition 2022 are Aditya, Joshi and Aditya Kumar from Synge Street, CBS, County Dublin, for their project titled A New Method of Solving the Bernoulli Quadrisection Problem. Congratulations, boys.
There we have it, our winners of the BT Young Scientist and Technology Exhibition. Hi, guys.
Hello.
You're the winners.
Hello.
We're very chilled. That's good.
Okay, first up, Aditya, Joshi, put up your hand so we know which is which. Aditya. Okay, so we have Aditya, Joshi on the left. Aditya Kumar, did you just hear what we said? You've just won the BT Young Scientist and Technology Exhibition. Just checking in case you hadn't.
I'm joined by the winners of the 2022 BT Young Scientist and Technology Exhibition, Aditya, Joshi and Aditya Kumar. Congratulations, boys. So how does it feel to win?
It felt static. Surreal, yeah. I couldn't believe it until a couple hours ago that we just won, so.
Yeah, it felt like a dream.
And tell me a little bit about your project and what exactly it is.
So basically, in our project, we took an old problem, which is the Bernoulli quadrisection problem, and then we used a modern technique known as particle storm optimization, which is invented in 1995, and it used it to solve this problem, and it worked out really well. So then we were able to use that method and then solve lots of other problems with it. So then we decided to try to solve a very much harder and more complex problem, and then that worked out really well as well. So in the problem, it was proposed by Professor Jens Wiegen, who is a professor of mathematics at the University of Bonn. And then in the problem, you have to distribute tons of components evenly across the four quadrants in such a way that all the weights are even, and the distance that have moved in total is the smallest you can get it. And then this problem also has a practical application in the real world, which is that it has uses in the design of electronic circuits. So where you would be placing tons of components onto a PCB and you would need them to be evenly spread out. Also the distance they have moved would need to be the lowest you can get it. So the production cost would be low, for example.
Is that the sort of area you guys might want to go into in the future, like mathematical things, geometry, or are you kind of looking at other things as well?
I'm kind of looking at either being a software engineer or a doctor, two very different things. So I'm kind of stuck between two roads. But I still have 3 years left to make that choice.
Plenty of time.
I'm probably going to go to the software engineering or robotics kind of thing, because I'm into computers and coding and stuff. Also, I kind of want to start a business, but I have no ideas as of yet.
Brilliant. Well, congratulations again, and thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us. And happy birthday as well. I believe you just turned 15 today.
Thank you.
A real double whammy, I think, today.
Yeah. There's also an Indian festival going on today, so.
Oh, wow. There's a lot going on today.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, guys, for taking the time to talk to me.